everyone. I'm back from seeing the hotly anticipated Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2, and I wanted to go full mark on this spoiler-free review for you. The first Guardians of the Galaxy surprised me by being so fresh and exciting. It had funny characters and just the right amount of heart, in my opinion. Sure, like all the Marvel movies, it probably would have benefited by having a stronger villain, but I still thought the movie was fun as hell, and I was really intrigued for the sequel. Soon, we started seeing advertisements for the sequel, and it looked like what I wanted, more of the same in a brighter and arguably bigger package. Then I went to see the movie, and once again, we're seeing one of those movies where the trailers are just full of footage that don't make it into the movie. And honestly, I'm pretty disturbed by it this time. You know, I want to applaud Marvel for taking such a big risk by creating this sequel that's honestly a drastic departure from the first movie in the franchise. I don't think that they've ever taken such a wild swing in any of their other properties, so I guess it's nice to see a big group of companies like Marvel and Disney really take a chance on one of their most beloved new properties. The first thing I noticed, and it was pretty glaring to me, was that none of the original cast are even in this movie. None of them. Sure, they're on the poster, they're in the trailer, but none of the main human actors are actually in this movie. I'm calling bullshit on that. Apparently, this movie also just entirely takes place inside of Groot. That's right, this movie takes place inside of a giant tree. I guess Baby Groot was just too cute and they decided to age him back up for this movie. That said, Groot never speaks at all this time, and I'm guessing that they did that so they could save money on hiring Vin Diesel's creepy ass.
What's wrong? Am I the only one that's saying it? Look at her. She's so fucking beautiful, it's like you can't even do an interview with her because you're just like, da 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 da. Right?
Okay, get this. It turns out there are owls living inside of Groot, like sentient owls, and they're all engaged in some sort of, I don't know, familial drama and owl politics. It's kind of like The Sopranos, but with owls. It's not quite like Modern Family with owls, though. The first movie, if you remember, has like a really cool classic rock soundtrack with a ton of hit songs that most of us were at least vaguely familiar with. But in this sequel, they offer some super basic pop soundtrack by a band called Owl City. Come on, is that Owl the ideas you guys had for this movie? Did I mention the sequel's animated too? Who signed off on this absurd sequel? It obviously wasn't James Gunn, as apparently this movie wasn't even written or directed by him. It was directed by Zack Snyder. I guess this is proof that we can't trust Disney with any of their properties. What's next? Star Wars Episode 8 featuring the cast of Star Trek as played by owls? Rest assured, I don't think I'll be seeing this train wreck again. Maybe if I had opted to see it in theaters instead of finding a copy of it in the day-old bread garbage behind the nearest Jimmy John's, maybe I would have found myself a little more engaged and a little more into it. But I highly recommend you pass on this just terrible movie. I'm going to give it 0 out of 10 owls. Like, share, and subscribe, nerds!